Fala galera, beleza? Meu nome é Pedro, esse é o Learn Portuguese, and in today's video we're going to be talking about the prepositions a and para. And here we go! Okay, so before we begin, I have to say that we're going to be using articles in this video, and if you haven't watched yet, I just made a new video a few days ago about articles in Portuguese, so if you haven't checked that out, I'll leave any card right there so you can go and check it. Then come back to this one and you understand it better, all right? Deal? Okay, let's go. So the prepositions a and para in Portuguese have different meanings. But in today's video, we're going to be talking about a specific case, which is when they come along with the verb ir, with the verb to go. For example, if I want to say go to the beach, should I use a or para in Portuguese? Actually, this is something that bugs many native speakers as well who don't know how to use it properly. Because most of them will just use para in all the cases. But actually, the difference is, for the preposition a, we have to use it when the movement is short and also it's a two-way movement. For example, if we go to the cinema, then we have to use a. So, cinema is a masculine noun. The sentence then would be ir a o cinema, which is go to the cinema. But in Portuguese, we tend to take the prepositions and the articles and mix them up. So I would take the preposition a and the article o, and I'm going to mix them. That becomes ao. So for this example, we would say ir ao cinema. A plus o becomes ao. On the other hand, if you say ir à praia, to go to the beach, praia is a feminine noun. Thus, it will be a praia. Then the sentence would be ir à a praia. Now we have two as, the preposition and the article. And what do we do in Portuguese? We also mix them up. And that becomes this a with a graphic mark. And notice that it's pointing the other way. So we need to use this one and not this one. They mean completely different things. In Portuguese, we call the first one acento grave. And the second one, which is wrong, we call it acento agudo. They have different functions and I'm going to cover them later. But anyways, the sentence would be ir à praia. We take a plus a, mix them up, and that becomes a with a graphic mark. So, some common examples with the preposition a would be, for example, ir à praia, ir ao cinema, ir ao supermercado, ir ao shopping center, etc. So the preposition a is for short and two-way trips. So what about longer trips? For those, we have to use para. If I want to say that I want to go to São Paulo in Brazil, I would say ir para São Paulo. Just a side note, cities have no gender, so it's neither o São Paulo nor a São Paulo. It's only São Paulo. So, ir para São Paulo. Go to São Paulo. If I want to go to another city, let's say I live in São Paulo and I want to go to a city next to São Paulo. Well, if you compare the distances, it's in theory a short trip. But for trips, we always use para. So, from São Paulo to Campinas, for example, we would say ir de São Paulo para Campinas. So it's going from São Paulo to Campinas. So a quick summary. If it's a short two-way trip, we need to use a. If it's a longer trip, we have to use para. Now, let's take a look at some exercises. I'll leave those in the screen and you can just answer and reply back in the comments. Alright, galera, that was the video on a and para. I hope it's clear, I hope you understand everything, and if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell to get all notifications for all the videos. And if you like the content, leave a like, leave a comment, it really helps me bring more Portuguese content to you guys. And that was it for today's video, so I'll see you next time. Até a próxima. Tchau, galera. Fui!